Jason.
Hi, how are you, sir?
So well.
Awesome.
A pleasure to talk to you.
Pleasure to talk to you, too. Now, you're from Montreal, which is amazing.
It's an amazing.
I grew up here, and I'm 42 years old. I have a little Jewish grandma that grew up on Mariette.
I have one out of two of those.
Well, it's funny because when I grew up, I would watch reruns of the old Star Trek, and she would tell me, I used to babysit him when he was a boy.
You're kidding.
I swear. And I don't know if that's true or not. But you.
Well, where did she live?
She lived on Mariette near Summerlet and Terrebonne.
Well, it could be. That's where we lived.
Yeah. Well, and she said, I used to watch him. So just thought I'd tell you that before we start the interview.
Well, it brings us closer.
Yeah, exactly. So do you mind doing a station ID? Are you okay with that?
No, let's do the interview.
Okay, no problem. That's fine.
That's the first time I've been asked before I do the interview.
Well, no, I just figured I'd get it out of the way.
Yeah, no, let's not do that right now.
No, no problem. All right. So you're with the Rockman here, and I have the pleasure of talking to Mr. William Shatner on the phone. Sir, how are you doing today?
I am so glad to be with the Rockman.
I'm happy to have you. It's an honor.
Yeah.
We're really, really excited to have you here in Montreal. I met you at the Ottawa Comic Con. Probably a few months back, and you're a gentleman, sir. You really, really are really nice
to the
fans.
Well, thank you for saying that. You know that you and I will be together at the Comic-Con that takes place a week from this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Yeah.
A week, 10 days from now. So I'm saying to your audience, hey, if you enjoy Rockman, you'll enjoy the Comic-Con.
Well, there's no doubt that we're going to really be happy to have you here. And you're a native Montrealer.
I am. I was born on Girouard, and I grew up on Marcel, and I went to high school at a school that no longer is there, West Hill High School, and I graduated from McGill.
And you and I went to the same elementary school because I spent 6 years at Willingdon.
No.
Yeah.
Did you play King of the Mountain off those bins that where the coal trucks would go?
I don't think we had the coal trucks there, but what we did, we had those grates that were over the windows, and we used to try to throw tennis balls into the corners of them.
No, but didn't you fight to be on top of these bins, and we called it King of the Mountain?
Really? I don't know if they were there when I was there.
Oh, they might have removed them since they probably went to oil.
I was there in the 70s, so no, there was no coal there for sure.
Well, how'd they heat?
I don't know. I just went there, and I was happy to be there.
But you froze your little ass off because they didn't eat anything.
Probably that's why I don't have great memories from Willingdon.
Right.
So now, when you come to Montreal, are there certain spots you like to hit up? Are there certain restaurants that you like to go to?
Well, everything's changed, you know.
Right.
Ruby Foo's used to be the Chinese restaurant that the family would go to on Sundays.
On DeCarry, yeah.
And to my childhood brain, that's the greatest Chinese food ever invented. Probably not as good as I remember.
Right.
But still, and then there were all kinds of restaurants that we went to as kids. But I've watched some cooking shows on the Travel Network on Montreal.
Yeah.
And there are restaurants that have just recently come into being, or the last few years, that are, like, sensational.
Well, there's a lot of there's an upcoming surge of young chefs that are really making a name for themselves. Chuck Hughes, the guys over at the Liverpool House.
Well, I'll tell you what you got to do.
Yeah.
You got to give me a recommendation or two so that I can go to when I come into Montreal. I got to go to these new chefs.
Yes. Well,
so when we're off the air, I'm going to give you my web thing, and you'll have to wire me the names of a couple of restaurants.
I will be sure to do that. And when I can
Rockman suggests.
Rockman's, yeah, and definitely you have to hit up Moishe's. It's an institution here.
Well, Moishe's has been around forever.
Yes.
See, now Moishe's is a cultural event.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's going to be crowded.
No, they'll always have room for you. That I can promise you. I'll get you in there if you need to go.
Moishe's like one of the great old steakhouses.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And it's, yeah. It's
well, that is certainly would bring back memories because my father had his little company on St. Lawrence Street.
Okay. What did he do?
He was a clothing manufacturer.
Oh, nice. So he's in the schmata business.
Yeah.
Very cool. So now you take a lot of time doing these conventions and you love it.
Well, I don't go to many, but the ones I go to, I really look forward to. I'm going to be on stage with Patrick Stewart, for example. I don't know whether it's once or twice, but somewhere there on Saturday, certainly, I'm going to be on stage with Patrick, and we'll have the best time, and I'm sure the audience will come along with us and have a great time. We'll answer questions and make each other laugh and hopefully make the audience laugh, and if not, it'll be a cause for great depression.
Well, and
we'll have fun. Patrick and I will have fun together on stage, and people will come and see.
And for all those that have never seen you guys interact together, I did see the movie that you did, The Captains, which was fantastic, by the way.
Thank you so much. A documentary called The Captains. I've got a new documentary called Get a Life, which examines asks the question, who goes to Comic-Con, mm-hmm. who goes to these play things, and why are they there? And the answer I get is stupefied me. I had no idea. And I'm not going to tell you the answer. I want you to see the documentary, Get a Life, and you will discover what I discovered to your amazement.
Yeah, and I saw you last year in Toronto when you were talking about this and this film that was coming out. And when's the release date for that?
Well, it played in USA television.
Okay.
And it's now out there in its various forms.
So you can get it on demand.
Go to WilliamShatner.com. It'll tell you the status of Get a Life.
All the info will be there on your website.
Yep.
Right. Well, Mr. Shatner, I won't keep you too long. I wanted to thank you so much for taking the time and talking to us. And we're really
It was my pleasure, and I just want to remind you, I hope the Rockman will be at the Comic-Con. I mean, Rockman at Comic-Con has a musicality all of its own.
Rockman will be at the Comic-Con, that's for sure.
Friday, Saturday, and Sunday of next week.
Absolutely. Thanks for taking the time, sir.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Take care.